Let's see what I'm going to do today. There's a new event with 13 days. I'll go back.
This is has its final day. Don't rush.
Open yet? Let me just heal. This is part of the Anara. This is let's see this first one. Culinary dream. Think of a new recipe.
Time to go. Time to go.
I think I tossed the imbro on this guy once. I was passing by and thought it was one of the regular ones that gets confused around. It's a Nara? I'm sorry that Nara had to see me in such a messy state. Hi Nara, I'm Arachatora. You are? I'm Ignis. And Paimon's name is Paimon. Ignis and Paimon, I see. Thank you so much. If fate hadn't brought us together, it would have taken me much longer to recover. How long is a little longer? I'm ashamed to admit that something like this happened once before because of bad mushrooms. The Nilotpala lotuses in the water bloomed and closed twice before I recovered. How could he keep track of time? Why confused? Bloomed and closed doesn't that take 2 days? Ah, 2 days, I see, so that's what a day means. You know, are really interesting. Are 2 days long or short? What do you think? Is it long or short? Long? Depends what the time was used for. Time is subjective and meaningless. Yeah. Yes, you understand the principles of the forest well. To the forest, life's born, life grows, and life returns to the earth. All days don't need such concept as a day. You're not making much sense to Paimon. But if you are our Shaptora, aren't you related to our Apakati? Nope, why wouldn't they necessarily be? But, oh, how did you... Oh, it's complicated to pay attention to all those names that sound alike. But you are our Apakati's older brother, alright? No, how did you know? Arbakash is my younger sister. I was confused. Perhaps it's different for an hour. Anyway, let us bring you up to speed. We bring our up to speed in this event so far. Festival itself is coming again. What should I do? I haven't had the most important cooking ingredient yet. Festival itself should be the best time to prove the greatness of mushroom dishes to Arasaka, Arapas, and Arapvala. So Arasaka, Arapas, Arapvala. Even our names are so difficult. Arashatora, where is your brothers? We drift apart on our paths of training, just like a river branches into streams. So we split apart, right? We train to cook supreme delicacy, But they refuse to acknowledge mushroom dishes. How could they not see that the ham mushroom is unmatched? Anyway, we decided to complete our own dishes and compete with each other later. Pavel totally understands the pursuit of delicious food. So where's your ham mushroom? Marana has been spreading rapidly. Even the ham mushroom's habitat has been taking over. The routine zone. Pavel hopes Rana is doing okay. It's withering close. I have probably taken the precious mushroom there. I'm sure you're aware how very, very dangerous Manara's territory is. Without the head mushroom, I could only try the strange mushroom that no Arnar has ever tasted before. And we witness the outcome of it. How embarrassing. Now that Paimon thinks about it, the withering Miranda we've dealt with before, right? Very broken sweat. Oh, unbelievable, you can fight Miranda. Well, it does make sense since Miranda could heal me with the power of Lesser Lord Kusanali. It actually wasn't him, it was probably Tainar that I used. Then removing the effects of Miranda shouldn't be a problem. So, I want to ask Norris to come with me to the head mushroom's habitat. Our chance to taste extremely delicious mushroom dish, Enos, let's help him so that these siblings can get back together. We did give Arapakati our word. We're just doing it for food. We're killing two birds with one stone, what's wrong with that? Alright. It's in the cave ahead. Please come with me.
Time to go.
Is that the cave that was flooded? Because I think I messed there and lowered the level. Better found the head mushroom to. It's a room and touch the cap every time it passes by. Cooking of Ramona is the final goal of my cooking training. Hey! Yeah, I have messed that already.
Time to go!
Waiter is very strong, feels horrible, hope that mushroom is fine. I think we cleared this area of withering. There's probably another one for the quest. But
solidify.
I have. What do you need? Yelan, I don't. I have Sayu. What do you need? Try to exit the map. There's a gap there. Okay, let's try it. But what? With her spinning ability?
I'm so sleepy.
I did it once. I guess I was around here. I was checking this area. So I kind of got stuck gliding here. He was constantly trying to fly back, but he couldn't make the turn right. So after a while, the character went far enough, and I showed up in Mondstadt. I don't really remember where in Mondstadt, but yeah, I guess there's a fixed place where we get teleported when you get too far out of bounds.
Sure.
instead of a mushroom. It does look a little larger than normal shrunking, does it? Especially pick later once the weakness zone has been eliminated.
Can't see. Stabilize.
No.
I will have order.
Windstrider.
Fallen Amber, help!
Enshroud.
And the head mushroom I have always been dreaming about. The mushroom would still be the same without your sweet scent. This mushroom does smell really good. Anyway, let's get out. Just that. Yeah, what's special about the head mushroom anyway? A mushroom is a head of mushroom. What's the difference? It's made. Mushroom instead of a head. Probably. What do you mean by probably? I'm so lucky to have met both of you. It's the smell of a fully mature head mushroom. It's richer than ever. So you grow well even when Mara not the cover. You're a habitat. You're amazing. So can we taste it? Of course, putting aside how you've helped me, serving the most delicious mushroom dish to Nara again has always been the goal of my cooking training. And yeah, head mushroom. Our chator immediately starts cooking. The fresh aroma of the mushroom bursts out from the pot. Once it's ready, our chatora serves it to you and Paimon. Should it be considered disappointing or conforming to expectation, it's because it's tasteless. Besides that, it's filled with vitality and too tough to the point of being difficult to chew. It's done. My cooking training has finally been completed successfully. What do you think? I'm sure it's the best elixir to Nara. How should Pam put this? Chew forcefully. Swallow forcefully. It's edible if tried hard enough. At least it isn't poisonous. It's a little too early for me to have something like this. It's edible if tried hard enough. It's a very fragrant mushroom indeed, but its texture and taste doesn't really suit us. How could this be? When I served to the other Nara from before, she said it was good. Which Nara? From before? I served my mushroom dish to a Nara some time ago, and because it was so good, she swallowed it with so much vigor. It should be fine. And just like every Aranara grows different leaves, the taste of the mushroom may not suit all Nara. It wasn't any hard to chew, even. Right, speaking of leaves, are Aranara not afraid of fire? You look like you are covered in leaves. Of course it's scary. Forest fires sometimes raise entire forests until only barren ground remains. But it's for my cooking training. Yeah, so keeping my fear at bay and controlling the temperature of the flames is also part of my training. So that's how it is. Anyway, guess it's time to go back. Our Pakati is waiting for you guys. Yes, I'll head back to Varnarana immediately. I can't keep my precious sisters worrying about me. As for the others, Arzaka, Arapas, and Arafalas are around Gandharvaville, Alpa Woods, and Devantaka Mountain. Thank you, Godinara. It is dazzling like the sun. The poem is quite amazing, too. I'll leave my sister's request to you. Why is poem only quite amazing? No, don't worry about that. Anyway, I don't know how to repay you for all the help you've given me. I decided to give you my supreme delicacies. Perhaps you grow fond of its taste as you age. If Paimon modifies this recipe a little, it should be able to become a pretty good original dish. Okay. I'm so happy that I was able to gather the head mushroom, complete my cooking training, and get to know a strong and reliable Nara. Arbukata, Arasaka, Arapas, and Arafan will be grateful too. Narigans, are you... You're a good Nara. Grateful, why? Because by helping me, you're giving them a chance to taste the head mushroom. Okay, let's check the next ones. Yes, the poem must be the one we're looking for. You consume the dew and grow up quickly. Hello, you are our. What was it again? I forgot it's of the brother. Arzaka. Arzaka, are you Arzaka? Grow, turn into delicious dish. Doesn't seem to notice us. And Nara, so tall, so scary. Please, I beg you, don't pluck them. Oh, we won't do it. What's my intro? I grew these Zyton peaches little by little, ever since they were seeds. Wait, no, Ben Nara, how could you do that to someone else's Zyton peaches? Wait, does Nara have such a terrible habit? You didn't do anything, you haven't picked them. It's already scary that you guys didn't do anything. If you hadn't really done something, it would scare me to death. Hey. No, Arzaka, think about it. You've worked so hard on these Zeton peaches for your cooking training. You cannot back out here. You're not scared. So you're Arzaka. How do you know my name? Where did Nara all come from? To know my name at first sight. You said it yourself. We knew it a long time. You said it yourself. Flowers are caused by a loose stone. It's over. My name will be used in terrible curses. Please spare me. Rather than give you the Zyton peaches, I'll do anything. Easy now. We're actually here because of Arpakat's request. Arpakat? Ah, my dear younger sister. Sunlight in the dense forest. You bring Arasaka up to speed, the event so far. How come Festival Utsava is already approaching? Oh, are you two the Nara who have come to participate in this Festival Utsava? Sorry for calling you up a Nara. You must be good Nara because only good Nara can enter Vanarana and participate in Festival Utsava. Festival Utsava is coming. If I give up my cooking training and return to Vanarana now, no, but I can't skip the Festival Tsava either. Why are you getting more nervous instead? Don't you still have the Zeton peaches you planted? And that's not enough. There has to be the taste of happiness. Without it, Zeton peaches will just be Zeton peaches. Arachatora, Arapas, and Arfala all don't believe that Taste of Happiness exists. I will make it to show them, and show them. And I want Naruto to try it too. The Taste of Happiness you're talking about. Taste of Happiness, I tried it once. Taste of Happiness, it's white, crumbles when you rub it, turns into white Veluca, but it's not hard and painful like Veluca. Start in a hard bubble. Huh? What's white Veluca? Well, Veluca refers to white sand, right? Oh, how did you know that? But what's a hard bubble? I'm okay to figure that out. Where can we find that taste of happiness? Why are you asking me? Do you want to take the taste of happiness before I do? How scary. We only want to help you. Help me with what? I can get it myself. It's just that there are a lot of Nara walking about. And one that smells like Nara Veluca. Too many Nara. I'm scared. If they're worth your Nara, I could do it then. Okay, true, I can get it, but I don't dare to enter Gandharvaville. There are too many Nara there, and all the dead trees, I'm scared. There are a lot of dead trees. I have a Nara friend living inside, but a long, long time has passed. He's changed now and can't hear my voice, so there's an old man there. Knows him. So, the taste of happiness you're talking about can actually be found in another view. Taste of happiness is not grown from the ground, but made by Nara. I really want to taste it again. I still remember the first time I tasted it and how happy I was. It was amazing, amazing taste. We were in the forest together with Nara friend. Counting the number of patches of sunlight that fell between the leaves. We sang together and tried the taste of happiness together. Every time I see the sunlight on branches, I will think of him. Every time I think of him, I remember the taste of happiness. I think he's talking about sugar. Yeah, that is the taste of happiness. So, I want to let Arbacate taste it. And when Festival starts, I want Nara to taste it too. Come on, sis. Then leave it to Ignis and Paimon, right, Ignis? I want to have happiness too. Really? You're not lying to me? Nope. But there are so many people in Gandharvaville. Who should we ask for clues? I know. Not long ago, I saw an arrow passing by here. Going to Gandharvaville. And he had it with him. He had a bulging thing on his back. And it's what Nara used to carry things. Bulge on the back. And it's probably a back or a bag or a back basket. Got it? It'll help you find the taste of happiness now. Oh, you don't have to climb back here again. Hello, calling any help, looks strong and energetic. What can we do? Okay. From what view?
Time to go!
Well, this is a merchant. Oh, but it doesn't have anything. Huh, this guy has a backpack. No, I talked to him before. He just got tired from crossing the castle.
Our recent
that?
It was great. How definitely have enough for a grand feast this time.
Wouldn't be somebody.
Total of 5 dusk birds.
Oh, it's probably this guy. Hey. Banara. First time here, first time, same blind. No, sorry, first time, he's done that already. Ah, this guy. So the nerd be the one Arasakuto. Hello? Hello, Kong. Can I help you? You actually want a certain thing. Of course, everyone comes to here to get a certain thing, but just saying a certain thing doesn't mean I know what this certain thing is. Paimon gets it. Let's put it this way. White cubic. Right, it crumbles like sand when crushed, and it has to be packed in a hard bubble. A peculiar description. It's not clear what it is from what you said, but what does this white and cube thing you described do? Here's the thing. You know what this is good for? It's edible. An edible white and cubic thing. Oh, I know what you want. What's so funny? White cubic crumbles when crushed, becomes sand and can be eaten. Isn't it just sugar? The hard bubble, are you talking about the glass bottle that sugar is stored in? My goodness, hard bubble. What, so it's sugar? This is awkward. Oh, I laughed so much I cried. I focused on my business the past few years. I don't even remember when it was the last time I left like this. Speaking of which, it's really nostalgic. I remember a long time ago, when I was still a child, I once had a friend who ate sugar for the first time, and the friend said similar things. This white cubic thing is delicious, so awesome, the taste of happiness. He was really amazed at them. It was so long ago, and now that I think about it, I don't even remember what it looked like. I thought this guy was just a traveling merchant passing by. A guy that actually lives here. I'll give you this bottle of sugar as a gift in return for the laughter. Okay. Hold it carefully. The heart bubble might be hard, but it can still break if dropped. Heart bubble. So the taste of happiness is the sweetness of sugar. It was a little embarrassing, but at least we got it in the end. Let's bring the bottle of sugar to our side. My family has always been a merchant group on the move from the chasm to Somero. We import rare gemstones from Liyue and then send spices over. Once, because something came up, I can remember. Anyway, my father left me in Gandalfville for a very long time. Remember, I was in the forge and I made a friend. We ran around together. Then, I don't remember what happened later. I can't remember his name or what he looked like. I only remember it being a really happy time. Then my family came back and picked me up. I also thought to go back and look for him, but I never had the opportunity. And I eventually forgot about this experience. If it wasn't for you asking me for sugar, I would have forgotten all about these things. Why would it be like this? Do I have a special quest sugar? No, I don't think so. Azaka, this is the taste of happiness you wanted, right? You brought it back from Gandalfville. That's the one. I didn't think you'd get it so quickly. Is it real? You didn't just make something up to trick me, right? It would be a miracle if you were able to make anything that made sense up from your description. If you're worried, just try it yourself. You didn't put anything strange in it, did you? Of course not. If you're not trying it, we're gonna take it away. No, wait, don't take it away. Let me try it. Don't take it away, right? I'll try it now, right now. It's real. This is a taste of happiness. This isn't the first time I tasted it, and yet I still feel so happy. I didn't expect to ever taste this again, but what's wrong? How should I put this? The taste of happiness is the same as before, but for some reason, I don't feel as happy as the first time I tasted it. Could it be that the sugar he gave us was not sweet enough? No, it's not a difference in the taste, but when I ate it with my friend in the past, that was the first time I tasted the taste of happiness. Somehow, I feel that I was much happier back then. Why is that? That's normal. Even if it's the same dish, the taste is different every time Ingus makes it. Paimon's mood is different every time Paimon eats it too. Indeed? No, it can be. There must be a way for me to be as happy as then. I know, I had it with a friend at that time. So the taste of happiness should be shared with friends for it to be delicious, right? That must be it. You're a good Nara and you found the taste of happiness. You are my friends. I'm going to make it for you. Oh, we're friends. Arazaki starts cooking right away and adds peaches and sugar into the pot. Arazaki then hands the finished products to you and Paimon. As expected, it doesn't have much flavor other than the overwhelming sweetness. Maybe this is just the taste of happiness. What a happy flavor. It's exquisite. Yes, this dish is quite happy. And you thought, too sweet. Paimon thinks it's much too sweet too. Really? Oh, I guess I must have put too much sugar. But it's true that the taste of happiness is happier when shared with friends. It is different from the happiness I felt the first time I had it. But eating with you guys, I feel a different kind of happiness. As long as you're happy. Now, I had doubts about you guys in the beginning, but you didn't hold any grudge, and you helped me find the taste of happiness. I was able to complete my Supreme Delixie with your help and complete my cooking training. It's nothing, really. No, how's it nothing? You've helped me so much. That's right, I know. I'll teach you how to make this dish so you can share the taste of happiness with your friends. If you modify the formula and add a little something extra, it should make a good snack. I just have to let them taste this Supreme Delixie and they will understand what the taste of happiness is. Arpacat will surely like it. And now let's go to another one. Oh, it was active already.
Time to go.
Taking a stroll in the middle of a downpour certainly rouses the spirit. But it's best to dry your clothes as soon as possible after the rain stops.
It smells so good. Someone cooking around here. Oh. perilous penmanship. A huge leaf someone has written on it with a message in writing. The seventh time, Russ covered the leaves. After some tests, I noticed that water from tributaries is filled with sand and mud. It has an earthen taste, not acceptable. The third time the frost covered the leaves, it's raining again, not acceptable. The 60th time the frost covered the leaves, after some tests, I noticed that water from a river's main stem makes much more aromatic soap, but it still isn't enough, not acceptable. The 80th time the frost covered the leaves, it rained as soon as I finished my soup. Luckily, I wore a hat. The quality of this water isn't bad. I didn't know Aranara could write human language. Biscuits. Hey, he wasn't there. Well, what's cooking here? In there? Grandma's mouth is watering just from the whiff of it. Looks like some kind of soup, looks like water. Paimon can't tell what's inside. Hey, what is it? The person cooking it isn't here. Come on, it's right. What the hell? I think he wasn't supposed to spawn. And it smells so good. Let's have a mouthful while it's left unattended. We shouldn't. Paimon is just curious. Paimon, just take one mouthful, just one. Why don't you get a tummy ache after? You underestimate that, Paimon. The pot's smaller than it looks. The soup's gone. What? Smells good, but why doesn't Paimon taste anything? Grace Aramukunda, why are you Nara doing? Aranara, where on earth did you come from? From underground. Forget that. Why are you drinking my soup? Arapus worked very hard on that. It was Paimon. Hey, how could you betray Paimon like that? I told you should. I don't care who drank it. My soup's gone. You know how difficult it is to make soup here? One minute it's rainy, the other it's sunny. Speaking of which, Varuna contraption has been much more stable lately. And the weather has become normal again. Well, I could have started this quest before fixing it. Actually, it was us. I'm sure it was a good Nara, like the Nara who repaired Varuna contraption. It wasn't soup thieves like the two of you. Hey, don't be so mean. It just smelled too good to resist. If it's that difficult, why are you cooking here? The key to cooking must be collected every day, which is your pride as a chef, the will to never forget your dreams, your pride. Water, it's water. Water has a huge impact on the aroma of my soup, so it has to be made with the best water. I've been collecting water throughout upper woods to make soup with. After collecting water samples from as numerous as the leaves on a tree, I finally found the best living spring. It's the only water source fit for Festival South's supreme delicacy. You wouldn't get it even if I told you. Only that Nara from before. Speaking of which, Arbakat sent us. You bring our opposite speech on the event so far. You're not friends of my sister. The festival itself is coming. It's fine. I found a living spring and my spring delicacy is complete. It's in spot. Alright. Don't be sad. At least your soup was really aromatic. My living spring up Shivana live at its source. Wait so long for them to leave. And only collected a pot of it. No, you must get me another pot of living spring. Apshvana, what's that? You now really know nothing about the forest. They live in the water. And they have four legs, a tail, and they bite. Dogs? Perhaps also need dogs. Alright, and then what's an Ashvana? Forget that. I want my water, and I want living spring from there in particular. Alright, alright. We don't have a choice, let's go. Let's go. It must be living spring and no other. Okay. Bad. I don't think I ever got water. Living spring. More playable starts the river flowing across upland woods. Current Jawarpas, the soup made from such spring water, is a supreme delicacy, but one wonders if it's really any different from ordinary water. You're a bad Nara. Don't even think about tricking me with water from somewhere else. It's the water from the river source, the living spring that's cold and clean, just like moonlight. Arashatora, Arazaka, and Arafala wouldn't be so stupid if they grew up drinking this water. Only Arapakati, my sister. Well, what's next? Next up, we have to make me a new pot of soup. Receiving guidance from Arapas, you add some fruits and vegetables into the water and start cooking. A rather nice aroma slowly emerges from the pot. Once you're done, you taste the fresh soup together. It starts off lives up to your expectations. It does carry the aroma of the ingredients, but a soup without any condiments is just too plain. It has no flavor at all. What about the fruits and vegetables? They should have something. This is how the super delicacy should smell. What do you think? It can quench thirst as soup should. I think it would be better with some salt and pepper. Everything is better with salt and pepper. Grish Aramu Hukunda. You want to add salt? What a horrifying idea. Land with salt is land without life, and our Nara will be forced to shrink in seeds. Yet Nara wish to add salt. Soups are supposed to be bland. How do you Nara not even understand that? Then Nara from before told us a story after having a bowl of my soup. When we Nara children come home, the aroma of soup is the first thing we smell. As such, aroma is all soup needs. After that, she complimented the aroma of the soup I made. I've never forgotten that. That's why I won't believe a word you say. But just aroma isn't enough. But since you're the Nara of this festival, Tsava, I'm sure you received approval from Araja and Arapakati, so I'll try making a soup taste. Next time, I'll look for even better water so we can make even better soup. I don't think water is the problem. Really? Anyway, my cooking training has concluded. Alright, let's see what we can do about this special Utsava. I've taught you how to make the soup. It's a soup approved by the great Nara, so do give it a few more tries. But make sure don't forget to use good water. And you can just let's add some seasoning next time. It should be pretty good after that. Is there water that can give Taste soup. Okay, so the last one. Hey, this one was already empty when I finished the previous. I think this would be too low on the mountain. Oh, damn.
Chat! Fallen leaves. Adorn my... I hear everything! Can't see.
This is order. Gather.
Hi!
Chat! One with the forest.
Another one. Was there one next to the other two then, and I didn't notice? Huge leaf, someone has written on it with neat writing. Leaves turn yellow. I picked a fresh and tasty sunsetia. Branches turn green. I didn't find any fruit. Leaves are growing again. And 40 moons have passed. I picked some sunsetias outside the campsite and brought them back to Vanarana. But sister said they were still very unripe.
Time to go!
It's sleeping there. Well, more stuff. Okay, wake up. Hi there. Hello. Tasty fruits. He's in deep slumber. Alright, Arbogat mentioned that the path of dangers should do the trick. I'm gonna leave it to you. Oh, it's you. Long time no see. You know me. Well, where am I? Is this a cave? I'm feeling dizzy. Who are you? Why are you sleeping here? Who am I? So dizzy with everything. My name is Arafala. I remember now. So you're Arafala. We were wondering where you've gone. And here you were, sleeping in this cave the whole time. Arafala, you know my name? And Nara. He's wide awake now. Indeed he is. I'm not ready yet. Don't make porridge out of me. Why would anyone want to make porridge out of you? My sister said that if I'm always half asleep like that, Ben Nara will take me and make porridge out of me. Yeah, you do look pretty tasty. You do look pretty tasty. Yeah. Hey, don't make jokes like that. Nara found no way to cook you. Really? Really. Not kidding? No kidding. Anyway. Paimon name is Paimon, and this Taonar is Ignis Arbacatsendas. Arbacate, is she doing well? How long have I been here? How long, you say? Well, if Paimon recalls correctly, many, many moons ago, the seedlings sprouted from the earth and became trees. How many Arbacats tall were they again? 7, maybe, if that's the only option I have. Well, as expected, Venus, what an amazing memory. Oh, it's been so long, oh no. Anyway, let's bring you up to speed. First of all, so it's coming up. We bring our follow-up up to speed on the event so far. And it's time for official Tsava, is it? So Arbakat wants you back in Vanarana. But I haven't completed my cooking training yet. Weren't you sleeping? Paimon thought... Sleeping? Oh, I was just thinking about the past. It wasn't that serious. Is sleeping something serious for Aranara? How should I put this? We hibernate when we are in grave danger. Then we compress our memories and dreams into a seed. If the crisis is averted and the time is right, the seed will return to the forest and grow into Aranara again. It sounds really tough, sounds so convinced. Sounds really tough. But I know that all Nara must sleep. I had a Nara friend once. A golden Nara, just like you. I once came here with her to gather the unraveled fresh fruits. So, I've been picking them here since then. If she returns, or if I make new Nara friends, we can eat them together. I picked up many of them this time. Where did they go? So it's you who dropped those insidious we saw all along the way. Did I drop that many? But it's okay, I've kept the freshest and tasted with me. But still, how did I drop so many? I remember living with my brothers for cooking training, but they didn't know that fresh fruits are the best ingredients. But while I was picking fruits, a really huge monster appeared. The one I just fitted. The huge monster was 5 Arafalas tall and had a long tail. Even the ground quaked beneath its stomps. Besides that, I think I sensed Marana's aura inside it. And it was so tough. Even if Arama and Arabalika were there, it would take them some effort to tear it apart. Wait, they are that strong? Yes, but I'm not. So I had to hide here. I was thinking about the past as I waited for it to leave. And the next thing I knew, you two were standing in front of me. Speaking of which, we did see a Windrake on the way here. Is that the huge monster you mentioned? Is that how Nara call it? Perhaps, very likely. We've taken care of it. Well, I didn't expect Nara Inshu, who looks smaller than the monster, to be so strong. Alright then, let's go. Good Nara, let's eat fruits together. Just that? Just defeated Drake?
Keep up! Ha!
Okay, let's start cooking with the unrivaled fresh fruits. Let's drip it between the unrivaled and ordinary fruits. I understand, to Nara, all fruits may be the same, but they are different. Only strong trees can bear unrivaled fresh fruits. Strong trees sink first when the wind blows. The bearing of the strong trees, those unrivaled fresh fruits, are a blessing to us. Then our friend said, these fruits are so tasty, they sing in your stomach. Paimon can't wait to see what kind of delicacy will be made from them. Our father starts cooking right away. He divides the fruits equally, then gives a few portions to you and Paimon. You try the fresh fruits together, it's sort of lit. Come on, I could skip the previous ones. This one was automatically. So good, thank you. Strong trees. Wait, you call that cooking? The unrivaled fresh fruit itself is the best supreme delicacy. It doesn't need any extra processing to present its best taste. Just taste it and you will understand. It is tasty, but it's just like eating fruits. It is a fruit, after all. Yeah, Pamon guesses so. Don't you Nara have a dish where you cut fruits and serve them on a wooden board too? Do we? Wait. Are you talking about fruit platter? Is the fruit platter considered a dish? I think so. Yeah. It still seems a bit strange to Paimon. I don't be a stickler for things like that. Finding better ingredients is a form of cooking too. While searching for the ingredients, I can travel the forge and get closer to it. That's the true meaning of my cooking training. Is it? It sure is. I've picked arrival fresh fruits and made my supreme delicacy. My cooking training is complete. I can return proudly to Vanarana. Oh, I would have missed Festival with Sava if Narayans and Paimon didn't take care of that huge monster that blocked me here in this cave. Alright, hurry back to Vanarana. Indeed, indeed. Sister will scold me if I miss Festival with Sava. Just the thought of it is scary enough. Alright, sure, forget it. The four brothers. Let's return check our Pakati. This one didn't have the... fish for sales come, I must hurry up. It's sleeping. Okay, let's see. Selva salad. Selva salad. For the ingredients. This is the sweet one. Another star, Pamon. Drain her brain juice to dry to improve it. Thanks, rather traditional recipe, tomato, fresh and crisp fruit, slice and mix together gently, squeeze some roses, add this sweet flavor. Mint juice instead of sugar to avoid getting sickening sweetness. Oh, it should be it should still be a candy and have sugar in the ingredients. Okay, let's start just making one of each. Masala cheese balls. Where is it? Where is it? This looks nice. Now there's the dish that Pamela has drink her brain juice stretch and improve it. It is in fact a rather traditional recipe somewhere. The freshly cooked cheese balls give off a titillating aroma for a special technique has been used to mix the spices in the dough. A small bite and you see hot cheese oozing out immediately. Served with potatoes that were simmered until tender. This creamy combination will keep you full for a long time. What's the other one? Mushroom. This is the soup that was just plain water. No, there was no cheese or anything in the other one. Yeah, it's also a kind of unrelated dish. You should have fruits and stuff and just add some salt or pepper, like they said. And this one, mushroom hodgepodge. Okay, this looks more like what we were supposed to eat there. Another side dish, in fact, almost marrow. Along with some extra seasonings, Paimon selects three types of mushrooms and they were prepared and then cooked in a simple way. But the texture and flavor aren't bad at all. Yeah. And each one has a different bonus. Yeah, but I didn't like that those two don't use aren't really the recipe that we did there. There should be sugar here, and at the very least, some fruit here. Should be more like the things on the quest.
Huh?
I guess I left the dream of a river.
Keep up.
I got so mad, more mad than mad. Oh, why did the angle change? Horse is very dangerous as Marana is ramping there. Well, when they left, Arpakat reminded brothers to work together. But you started arguing right after leaving. Arachitora, you even ate strange things. Arpakat has decided. Arachitora not allowed to pick mushrooms until some sages have ripped 10 times. No. Exactly. What will we do if we brought back bad spores and mushroom monsters grew here? Rafala, you too. You went so far away from Vanarana to collect fruits. There are many bad things over there. Arachitora told us about it especially. That's right. Fruits need to drink water and Aradara need to drink water. So water is the best. Arapas, of all places you had to go to the Varuna contraption, don't you know that even Nara Varuna said water of Vanarana is the most delicious? You see, only the taste of happiness can bring happiness to our little sister. Arasaka, I heard you cause a lot of trouble for Narigus because your taste of happiness. How did she hear that? I didn't say anything. Everything I did was for the Supreme Delicacy. The purpose of making the Supreme Delicacy is to show the fruits of the cooking training. What's the point of training if you could only complete it with someone else's help? Arbakat thinks Arasaka needs to reflect on himself the most. Arbakat, we are here.
Oh, it's you too.
The Ignis shared Arbakat's trouble with Paimon and solved the problem at its source. Arbakat no longer needs to worry about brothers missing Festival Utsava for being in danger outside. It's all thanks to you. Our Pakatian brothers are all thankful. That's great. But there's something Paimon has always been curious about. Who is this Nara Varuna? She's a friend of Vanarana. A friend of Vananara from a long, long time ago. A golden Nara just like Nara Ignis. But Paimon still got another question for you. Is it about her brothers? Yes, Arbakachi. Which one of them is your biggest brother and which one is the smallest? The biggest and smallest? Their ages. Arbakachi understands. Just like tree rings, the children of the forest aren't distinguished by age. Then why are your brothers? Why are they your brothers and why are you their younger sister? We once had another friend, Narvaruna. She said she had a brother. When our Pakatian brothers listen to her talk about the brothers, Narvaruna looks happy and sad at the same time. That's how we understood. To one older brother, a younger sister is an important Nara. To a younger sister, an older brother is an important Nara. We thought it was great, and so our Pakatian brothers decided to become brothers and sisters. Narvaruna said this was great, we should cherish our family. That's right, we must cherish our family. There's one more thing Paimon's been wondering. Do our Nara need to eat? Humans cook ingredients into food, and the children of the forest can also make ingredients into food. Narvaruna taught us how Nara eat. That's why our Pakatian brothers started doing cooking training. But that's certainly unusual. It's like you're playing a game. Our Pakatian brothers are very serious because Narvaruna said that to be able to share food is a very happy thing. Oh, and Rapa said that Nara Inus knows how to cook too. Yeah, Inus cooking skills have been tested by time. Arpakat gets it. Nara Inus must come to fight Okisawa and cook with Arpakat's Bush League brothers. Impress them once again with real cooking skills and food that only Nara can understand, and our Nara will never understand. Try not to be surprised by them. Narpakat is looking forward to it. This festival Sava will be really great and amazing. But there's still more quests, aren't there? So I hope everyone is how Ron is doing. Safe and sound, hopefully we should check on her. But there's still more quests, isn't there? Was there another quest?
If you press a leaf between dry sheets of paper, you can make it.
Sisters are angry, so our Shatara is keeping a piece of head mushroom to the society represent time. Keeping a piece? Cooking on the head mushroom for now, Ignus was the plan. But sister said no mushroom picking before the society repents another 10 times. Without the scent of mushrooms, our Shatara feels bad. Archetora may sneak out from mushrooms when the sunset ripens only 9 times. So Archetora kept a tiny little piece thinner than the leaves. It will stay with Archetora. So embarrassing. That's a long wait. But at that time, maybe head mushroom in Vanna could grow bigger and have richer taste. Perhaps they'll grow into super triple head mushroom. Thinking about that makes our Shatara a little happier. Our father thought our Pakachu was going to cook our father into gruel. Luckily, our father picked many fruits. But our Pakachu? I gave several unrivaled fresh fruits to sister. She is less angry after eating them. Last time she was angry was when we made all that smoke in Vanarana. Our father will give her more unrivaled fresh fruits when that happens again. No, not again. But the fruits, thanks to the help of Nara Ignis, our father brought many unrivaled fruits. When Festival South comes, our father will show the training results to everyone. Thank you, Nara Ignis. It is because of your help that everyone can enjoy the taste of happiness at Festival Saga. The more friends to share the taste of happiness with, the better it becomes. So when Festival Saga comes, I will make sure every Aranara gets to have the taste of happiness. By then, I think Arvakachi will have a good time like everyone else. About the taste of happiness. Besides the taste of happiness, there is also the taste of sadness. It's a terrible salty taste, which makes you very sad even with just a small bite. But Nara seems to like the taste of sadness. I don't understand this. Could it be that sharing the taste of sadness feels happy too? Where's the other one? Where's the red one? Narayan's festival has not started, so food not ready. By the brothers. Arashatora, Arasaka, Arapas, and Arafela ran away with sobs after Arapakat got angry. Those weren't the names. Wasn't there an Arafala? They have been making food and repainting carefully. Thanks to our Inus, or they will keep seeing cooking training as the most important and forget Arapakat's words about no fights. But Narvaluna cooks many, many dishes. Brothers are afraid of fire, however. They didn't see the cooking clearly and started cooking training after Narvaluna left. Narvaluna's Golinara too. Narvaluna must know how to cook many, many dishes. Arshatora, Arazaka, Arapas, and Rafaela will take a closer look this time and learn about Nara cooking. So, where is that?